what this SPNX base component. I want everyone to answer one question. Do you know what is science communication? Can anyone answer me the question? What is science communication? Just in one line. A two-way communication of what? Right, but of what? Science of what subject? Topics. Sorry?
Science-related topics.
Right, right. And who is the receiver? And who is, the communicator? And who do you think, do you know one science communicator? Can you answer? Do you know one science communicator? He's a very popular science communicator. Actually, I know two very popular science communicators. Can you tell me? They are not from India, they're from United States of America. But do you know? Yeah, I'm just following the path of sir and making this presentation interactive. So one, if you know about Carl Sagan and Neil deGrasse Tyson, both of them are excellent science communicators. They are scientists, experienced scientists and science communicators, and their role in life is to reach out to audience and make science simple for them. And that's what science communicators do. What we do is we make the complexity of the technical part of science to reach out to audience which are not even part of scientific community. So it's basically bridging the gap between the non-scientific community and the scientific community. So that's what science communicators do. Now, without further ado, I want to introduce you with SCNX Space for Women. So SCNX Space for Women program is an initiative which empowers and uplifts the women community to pursue their career in STEM and space industry through different training and advisory activities from experts. This is one of my favorite times that is on the SCNX website. With the rise of the global space industry, we cannot ignore the involvement of the women community to push the human race forward in the exploration and experiments of the cosmos. But what are our mission objectives? We want to establish awareness of the value of space exploration in young girls and women around the globe. We want to foster and recognize by meaningful educational programs and courses in space sciences and beyond, we foster the best talents. Recognizing space pioneers, educators, and entrepreneurs, for their contribution to SCNX Space for Women program. We want to widen, work, and develop a space of global space community influence to boost the program scale and impact with national and international entities in the development and implementation of space policies to involve more women in the space industry and inspiring women workforce with critical thinking skills and cultivates a populace that understands and supports a robust space program. And finally, record for most spacewalks by a woman, that is 7 spacewalks, and most spacewalk time for a woman, that is 50 hours 40 minutes. We also have our upcoming representation from India. Her name is Shauna Pandya. If you know her, she is said to be the third Indian origin woman in space. Shauna is a neurosurgeon from Alberta, Canada. She was shortlisted from 3,200 people at the Citizen Science Astronaut Program. So, thinking of Citizen Science, how many of you know what is a Citizen Science Project? What is a Citizen Science Project? So, do you know what is a Citizen Science Project? Obviously, you know, sir. So Citizen Science Project, it's a new concept, as science communication is a new concept in India. I think I maybe, and people who are graduating from masters in science communication, they may be you know, the first generation to come in science communication this year. And the Citizen Science are projects that are done by scientific organizations all over the world to include audience and include the population which are not from science background, right? So Citizen Science projects are, we have, you know, analog astronauts projects as well. Those can be called as Citizen Science project. And then we also have, you know, projects where you are encouraged to use telescope. Even what SDNX is doing, right? What SDNX is doing is involving people who are interested in space science, but they probably don't belong to space industry. So they have various internships with them, and this can be known as a Citizen Science Project.
USA have taken webinars and training programs for schools, teachers,
for Buccleuch tablet, Google tools, US manufacturing and human exploration lower charges 2018 at US space and rocket sector. Huntsville, Alabama, selected among 100 qualified teachers around the globe and participated in Honeywell Educators Advocate Space Academy for Education Camp held at US Space and Rocket Center. We have Ms. Aatri Basu with her, who will be joining the team with me as Chief Technology Officer of SDNS. Aatri is an Indian born space scientist, physicist, space educator, mentor, and entrepreneur. She is the founder and CEO of Stellar Tech, a qualification that doubles post-graduation in space exploration systems and physics respectively. Junior Research Fellow in Accelerator Physics from EAE VRS India and 10 years of teaching experience in physics. We have Julia from Belgium, who is a storyteller and science communicator just like me. Julia has around 10 years of experience in media and communication in the international arena. She makes bridges and explores common grounds. She is mastering media innovations spread the message and to reach the public. She has a passion for space exploration and has joined the public to touch the public from different perspectives. We have this extraordinary woman with her. Her name is Priyanka Chaudhary. Priyanka Roy Chaudhary is a doctoral student at Warsaw University of Technology, Poland, and a field of research is experimental particle physics. She is working at the STAR Experiment Lab, Brookhaven National Library, Vienna, USA, in which her project is to study the quark-gluon plasma state of matter using heavy quark correlations. Besides PhD, she is working in the Space Movement Project of Space Development Nexus as a space educator. Priyanka is an alumni of International Space University in France and one of the recipients of the Dr. Kalpana Chawla Scholarship 2020. Also, she is a member of Space Generation Advisory Council Space Medicine and Life Sciences Project Group SGAC and Space Technologies for Earth Application Project Group SGAC. Before joining PhD, Priyanka worked as a trainee at Variable Energy Cyclotron Kolkata, a nuclear detector organization. She completed her master's in physics at National Institute of Technology, Durgapur, India, along with three research publications based on her master thesis of theoretical analysis of paramagnetics associated with gravitational waves as emitted due to coalescence of binary black holes. And then there is finally me, who recently joined SDNS as the Chief Operating Officer. I'm a science communicator who recently graduated from the University of Western Australia. I came back to India for a single purpose only, to increase the scientific literacy in India. The thing is, while I was studying in Australia and while I was pursuing my degree in Australia, I realized that there's so many talented Indian people, Indian women, talented scientists in India. Why don't we give them a chance? Why don't we increase our scientific culture? Why don't we increase our power and representing other countries? I'm also part of World Economic Forum and we have started a project that is to educate underprivileged in the field of STEM. And this is the power of SDNS women and the faces of SDNS women in science. But the question is, where do you start your career? And what kind of careers are in space sciences? So we have organizations like ESA, ISRO, NASA. We have organizations like SDNS, Space Generation Advisory Council, the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs, SpaceX and Blue Origin, and then other space economy, the other space startups that are being developed in India as well. My question to you is that what will happen if, you know, a scientific organization, a research organization goes to Mars? Because, you know, right now what we all are talking about is going to Mars and settling down, maybe going to the moon, organization out of the box. This is a very good, I like to have a question for this. What will happen if these two organizations are on the Mars? Any kind of conflict or anything like that? Right?
Yes, okay, whatever you do, there should not be any conflict. Because right. You have to go on a, okay, cooperative mode. Whatever I can do, whatever you can do. Mm-hmm. Yes, and both together we can do a better job than mm-hmm. individually.
And my intention, okay, I will tell you this story about me talking to one of the friends back in Australia who was in the Australian Navy. And they were talking about, you know, AI, and we're talking about robots taking up human jobs. Right? He was like, this is such a good thing, right? You won't have to do anything. Every labor and everything, you know, AI and robots will manage it and we will have the last ride. And I was like, no. You don't understand that how dangerous that is, because we will have certain legal implications to that. We will have to maintain a different government and we will have different policies for that, right? So it's same with Mars, you know, going to Mars or Moon or something like that. We don't only need scientists and engineers there, but we also need people who can manage. We also need politicians. We also need policy makers. We also need, you know, the architectures who design the settlements. So space is not just for people who belong to STEM, and space is not just for men. It is also for women, and we need to indulge in getting that equity on the ground. Because we are ending a phase where we're developing the ecosystem, it's really important that women should be ahead of everything. And the same with the careers, right? So space career, don't think that you cannot be part of it. And this is for women sitting here as well. Don't think that if you do not have any technical background, don't think that, you know, if I've never studied space sciences, I cannot be part of this race. You can be part of this race, and STX Women is there to support you in every way. You can be from law background and you can be part of space. You can be from business background and you can be part of space. Right? And how do you achieve your careers? But it's a question, right? You know, I said a lot of things here, and I'm like, ma'am, you said all of these things, but, you know, we cannot do anything about it. Where do we start, you know? So this is the question, where do you start, right? I was a student, you know, a year before, just like you, in a university. So I'm just like you, and I started my career with STNX, coming back to India, right? But where do you start it, right? You start with us, you start with STNX. I encourage women who are interested in space sciences to be part of our group. Please come to me. Please, if you want to be part of the group, if you want to have an internship, if you want to be part of that, you come to me. You come to Govind, and we will help you out for this. I have already told you the workforce we are working with, right? We have such inspiring women, STX women, for Space Force. And I would love to have you places in STX Space Force. And this is the end of my presentation, but I hope you guys enjoyed and I didn't take a lot of time.
Thanks. One question to you.
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is the longest duration of the woman in space?
So it started with
No. What was the longest duration of your stay of your woman in space?
So I think
she is from which country?
So I'm talking about
I'm asking question. How many hours and what is the minute? Because you have compiled so much, you know,
right.
And you are talking about the woman power, so that's why I have asked.
So So I can miss out a few points.
A Russian lady who spent 348 days in space. And the next is Sunita Williams. She spent 324 days in space.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is only for the information.
Just for information, yes. Everyone should know about it.
साथ मिलाकर के फैमिली के ऊपर हम लोग काम करते हैं और जैसे कि सुंदर मोदी सर ने इतना बढ़िया अपना स्पीच जो डिलीवर किया है, उसमें मैं देख रहा था कैसे प्रोफेसर के तरह सर इम्पैक्ट कर रहे थे, बात कर रहे थे, बता रहे थे, और बहुत सुंदर लग रहे सर आप ऑफ शेवाइट कल्चर आई एम ऑल्सो शेवाइट, तो ये बड़ा अच्छा मुझे लग रहा था। और यही संस्कार की मैं बात कर रहा था कि हम बहुत पढ़ा लिखा था उसमा लिखा, लेकिन अल्टीमेटली क्या हुआ कि एक डायनेस्ट बना। तो जब एजुकेशन और संस्कार अपने कल्चर को अपने बिलीफ्स को हम साथ जोड़कर चलते हैं, तभी हम किसी देश को किसी कंट्री को रिबिल्ड कर सकते हैं।
जब ऐसे व्यक्ति जिनको भोजन की जरूरत थी हमने कहा कि हम घर पर रहकर ही मास्क बनाएंगे, तो विद्यार्थी परिषद की महिला छात्रा बहने घर पर रहकर मास्क बना रही थी, जिनको सिलाई तक नहीं आती थी वो घर पे सुई चलाकर मास्क बना रही थी और उन्होंने घर पर ही मास्क बनाकर वो वितरित करने का काम किया। आज हम ब्लड बैंक में जाएंगे तो ब्लड की कमी बहुत हुई कोविड के चलते, तो विद्यार्थी परिषद ने ऐसे पूरे देश भर में ब्लड डोनेशन का कैंप लगाया। जब ये बात आई कि चीन से हमारी लड़ाई चल रही थी और विद्यार्थी परिषद ने एक नारा दिया कि हम स्वदेशी अपनाओं का नारा देंगे, और जब रक्षाबंधन आया तो विद्यार्थी परिषद की छात्रा बहनों ने घर पर रहकर ही राखी बनाने का कार्य किया और कोरोना वॉरियर्स जो अपने थे उनको राखी बनाने का काम किया। आज विद्यार्थी परिषद जब नारी सशक्तिकरण की बात करता है तो मिशन साहसी जैसे कार्यक्रम विद्यार्थी परिषद ने दिया, जिसमें हमने सेल्फ डिफेंस की ट्रेनिंग पूरे देश भर में विद्यार्थी परिषद हर कैंपस तक जाकर सेल्फ डिफेंस की ट्रेनिंग छात्राओं को देता है। ये इसकी शुरुआत मुंबई में 8 लाख छात्राओं से हुई और मिशन साहसी एक ब्रांड बन गया जो हमारे हर स्टेट के हर कॉलेज कैंपस तक हम ये कार्यक्रम करते हैं, जिसमें ट्रेनिंग कैंप विद्यार्थी परिषद द्वारा लगाया जाता है। आज ऐसे विद्यार्थी परिषद को हम इतने कम समय में समझ तो नहीं पाएंगे, पर इसे प्रैक्टिकल जो इसमें रहता है वो उसे समझ सकता है। आज हमारे लिए भी काफी सौभाग्य की बात है कि हम इस कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित रहे, इस कार्यक्रम के भागीदार बने और आगे भी ऐसे कई कार्यक्रम में हम पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे। और मैं गौर कॉलेज का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद व्यक्त करती हूँ कि उन्होंने एक बहुत ही सुंदर कार्यक्रम का आयोजन कराया। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद। जय भारत।
आपका और आपके संगठन का कोटि-कोटि हार्दिक धन्यवाद। Now I am delighted to call upon Shri Rahul Saraswat ji, Vibhag Sangathan Mantri, to share his valuable words.
डॉक्टर अब्दुल कलाम ने भी क्या हम सब जानते हैं कि सैटेलाइट लॉन्च व्हीकल SLV उन्हीं ने इस देश में उसे लाने का काम किया। हम बात करें बैलिस्टिक मिसाइल की तो डॉक्टर कलाम ने उसे इस देश के अंदर लाने का काम किया। इसी परियोजना के साथ साथ उन्होंने जो अग्नि मिसाइल और जो पृथ्वी मिसाइल इसी परियोजना का एक वो उसी में आता है बैलिस्टिक मिसाइल में। ऐसे करके जो हमारे देश में बहुत सारे वैज्ञानिक हुए तो ये यात्रा इसने सेंटर की 1960 से आज हम देख रहे हैं कि पूरी दुनिया में भारत की एक बढ़ती ताकत है कि हम नासा हो या और भी कोई देश हो इन सबको बड़े गर्व से कह सकता है भारत के हमने कई रिकॉर्ड बनाए दुनिया के अंदर। जब हम लोगों ने बात की जैसे 96 से लेकर आज चंद्रयान 2 तक का जो यात्रा है आज भारत इस इसरो संस्थान से इन वैज्ञानिकों से जो भारत की जनता है हम लोगों के साथ एक भावुकशाल है। चंद्रयान 2 का जब लॉन्च किया था चंद्रयान 2 और किन्हीं कारणों से वो 1-2 मिनट का जो समय था उसमें जो विफल हो गया था लेकिन पूरा भारत पूरे भारत की जनता उस समय इतनी भावुक हुई थी कि हम लोग उस गर्व को महसूस कर सकते हैं। सब लोगों ने कहा था कोई नहीं इस बार नहीं तो अगली बार। वो जो भाव था भारत की जनता का पहली बार हम सब लोगों को लगा इस देश की जनता ने वैज्ञानिकों से जुड़कर एक भावनात्मक हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी भी गए वहां पे और जो इसरो के डायरेक्टर थे उनसे जब गले मिले वो भावुक क्षण था। हम लोगों की आंखों में एक पानी झलक आया था कि वैज्ञानिकों ने कितनी ताकत से काम किया और हमारे देश की सरकार हमारे देश के लोग हमारे देश के वैज्ञानिक हम सब लोग एक परिवार के रूप में काम कर रहे हैं यही इस भारत की ताकत है यही इस भारत की बताया साक्षी जी ने बताया कि स्पेस की दुनिया के वुमेन्स ने कितना काम कर रहे हैं। कल्पना चावला की बात करते हैं सुनीता विलियम्स की बात करते हैं लेकिन मुझे आशा है आज देखकर एक दिन ऐसा आएगा कि साक्षी शर्मा की भी बात करेंगे आगे चलकर। पढ़ाई नहीं करते लेकिन पढ़ाई करने का अपने देश में आकर काम करना ये भारत है यही भारत की आत्मा है कि हम पढ़े कहीं भी लेकिन मेरा कंट्रीब्यूशन सुभाष बोस ने अपने भाषण में कहा था माय करियर फॉर माय कंट्री मेरा करियर मेरे देश के लिए होना चाहिए। मैं कहीं भी पढ़ूं मेरा करियर में मैं कुछ भी बनूं चाहे मैं डॉक्टर बनूं चाहे मैं इंजीनियर बनूं चाहे मैं शिक्षक बनूं कुछ भी बनूं लेकिन मेरा करियर मेरे देश के लिए होना चाहिए। इसीलिए विद्यार्थी परिषद इसीलिए इसी दिशा को लेकर काम करता है हर विद्यार्थी पढ़ने वाला स्टूडेंट अपना करियर अपने देश के लिए लगाए ताकि हमारा देश आगे बढ़े दुनिया में नाम रोशन करे। इन्हीं सब बातों के साथ समय बहुत ज्यादा हो चुका है वैसे भी ऊपर तो ज्यादा मुझे कुछ बताने के लिए मेरे पास है नहीं बस इतनी सी बात है कि हमारा कंट्रीब्यूशन इस कंट्री के लिए क्या हो सकता है वही सबसे ज्यादा बड़ी बात है क्योंकि इस देश को आगे ले जाने के लिए बहुत सारी लोग लगातार काम कर रहे हैं लेकिन इस देश को पीछे ले जाने के लिए इस देश को तोड़ने के लिए बहुत सारी ताकतें काम कर रही है उन ताकतों को भी हम लोगों को मुंह तोड़ जवाब देने का काम करते रहना चाहिए। इसीलिए आज भारत डिजिटल इंडिया की बात करें हम एयरवेज की बात करें रोडवेज की बात करें वाटरवेज की बात करें भारत दुनिया में तरक्की कर रहा है। अगर हम पिछले 4 साल की बात करें तो भारत ने सबसे ज्यादा रोड बनाने का काम वैज्ञानिक किया है। अगर हम एयरवेज की बात करें तो भारत में आज देखते हैं हमारी फाइटर प्लेन लड़कियां उड़ा रही है हमारी बहनें फाइटर प्लेन उड़ा रही है। हम बात करें एयरवेज की तो आज हमारा राफेल सीधा फ्रांस से उड़ के सीधा इंडिया में आ गया हम किसी को और की जरूरत नहीं पड़ी हमें। तो ये जो भारत सरकार और वैज्ञानिक और सब लोग मिलकर काम करें इस देश के लिए बड़ा गर्व की बात है। हम लोगों का कंट्रीब्यूशन इस कंट्री के लिए क्या हो सकता है इन सब बातों का हमें सोचना चाहिए इन सब बातों के साथ भारत माता की जय हो।
बहुत सुंदर अभिव्यक्ति राहुल जी। Now it's my pleasure to invite Director General Sir, Director Sir, T.K. Sundramurthy Sir, and Govind Ji for the launching of book authored by T.K. Sundramurthy Sir.
It's not only by me, my colleagues are also there.
So it's a joint effort.
Yes, it's a joint effort.
Yes. Please, sir. Please
joined together, we wanted to bring a book about nanosatellites, because such a kind of a book is not available anywhere. So we have searched and we thought, yes, it would be of highly useful to the educational institutions and then students to know what is a nanosatellite, how a nanosatellite can be built. Because now, nowadays, nano has become a okay mantra, okay, mini, micro, all kinds of things, you know. So that's why this book, almost, of course, this is the first book which I have contributed for the students' community. In fact, I am really proud to be here in releasing this book. Thank you so much.